Representative Orcutt, we are in the middle of a long stretch of House floor action that spans almost 2 weeks. Tell us about what your days have been like since February 23rd.
What our days have been looking like is maybe we've got a couple of meetings at 7 or 8 o'clock, and then we start going to floor action at 9. And what we do is we get a list of bills. We go and review what the bills are, try to find out from somebody who sat on the committee what the bill was, what the testimony was like regarding the bill. And then we can get a better feel for whether or not that meets the objectives of our district or not. We also learn about the amendments, any proposed changes that are being made to the bill. Then we go out on the floor and we spend 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours going through those bills, debating the amendments, debating the bill, and voting on the bills. Then when we've finished a list, we go get another list, start looking at more bills. And that's pretty much the way it goes. And it can start at 9 a.m. and go till 5 p.m, or it can go till 6, 8, 10, 11 o'clock at night.
Now, a lot of bills pass with strong bipartisan, if not unanimous support, but others don't. For example, on Saturday, there was a 5-hour House floor debate on the low carbon fuel standard mandate. Tell us about your opposition to this legislation.
Well, and that's a very good point. Sometimes we're working on Saturdays and sometimes even Sundays. In fact, we went from 9 o'clock Saturday morning until almost 7 o'clock Saturday night, running just 2 bills. And one of those was the low carbon fuel standard. A lot of problems with that. Ultimately, what their goal is to reduce carbon in the atmosphere. And I think that's a worthwhile goal. The problem is that it's going to drive up the cost of gasoline and diesel. So it's going to hurt consumers, one, when they fill their tank, and two, when they go buy just about any product, because about any product you buy was delivered somewhere on a truck. And not only that, but it goes even deeper than that, because the raw materials to make the product was probably delivered by a truck. So that's going to increase the cost of fuel, and it's going to increase the cost of food as a result. Any other products that you buy, if you order something online, if you go to the hardware store, it's all going to cost more. And the bill started out with some expedited permitting to permit plants to build the alternative fuels that we're going to need. But ultimately, it got amended out to where it's now going to be harder to build those facilities and to produce the fuel that we need. So we're going to be reliant on California or on foreign sources of oil, palm oil and other types of vegetative oils that probably are coming from rainforests that have been cut down and burnt. So it really doesn't do anything to improve the environment, and actually will probably do more to harm it. At the same time, it's raising fuel prices and the price of everything else you buy. For those reasons, I and a number of other people voted against it. In fact, we had bipartisan opposition to it. Unfortunately, there was just enough support to pass it out of the House.